in Ballina quickly, just to grab some more water. I had a bit of a pit stop, a little bit of a feed. It's quite amazing that I'm here actually, because this is my old stomping ground. I used to work at Soroka Cafe in Ballina, and then I used to live over at Lennox Head while I did university, so it's quite a nice little town to ride through. I'm just outside of Ballina, between Ballina and Byron. Come 52 kilometres in about 2.5 hours, so I've been making good time, but it just got really hilly around here, and I was just going up a hill and I think I just like pulled a nerve, or I don't know what I did, but my knee just started killing me. So I had to stop halfway up the hill and like massage it and give it a break, and then I've just gotten to the top of the hill now. So I don't know what I've done to it, but it's sore again, and it's just so hilly around here that I have to use so much more of my strength, and it's just so annoying. Anyway, I've got 70 kilometers to go today, so we'll see how my knee holds up, and hopefully it doesn't get any worse. I stopped at Newbury, which is just up the hill from Byron Bay. So there was a sign saying last fuel stop for 100 kilometers, so I thought I better just refuel some water and have my break then rather than later. Apparently a couple more hills on the freeway, so once I'm on the freeway it should be pretty smooth sailing. Just gonna get over all these hills first. Got 71 kilometers to get to Coolangatta, and I've covered 55, so doing pretty well. It's about 1 o'clock. Aside from my knee troubling me, everything else seems to be holding up okay, so keep trucking along. So I just went up a massive hill. The road's crap. Took me so much longer. My knee's just killing me. I'm pretty exhausted right about now. I don't know if you can see behind me. I'm right up on the range, so I've just gone over all the hills. I got Byron Bay just down in front of me, and I got 61 kilometers to Coolangatta. I'm just pretty concerned about my knee right now. Feels like it's like a nerve pinching, but it's on the top of the skin. It's not where the nerves are. So I don't know if I'm tearing the muscle a bit or what's going wrong with it, but it's really sore. So hopefully there's no more big hills that are going to put a lot of pressure on it, because I don't know if it can take it. So I'm just going to have some more Nurofen Plus and keep riding. The freeway now. Done 80 kilometers, which is awesome. I think I've still got about 40 to 50 kilometers to go. Because it's the freeway, it's super smooth, so it does mean that I can do a bit more faster time, faster average. So I seem to be able to average around 20k at the moment, 20 to 25. Which is great. It also means that I won't be having to be on the road so much. Plus there's none of that shock, all that shaking in the handlebars. It's bruising my hands really badly, so that's gone, so that's fantastic. It just would wear on your bones and your muscles and your joints, and it would just make everything hurt really quickly, whereas when you're on this sort of road that's nice and smooth, you don't have that effect, so it's just energy levels that you need to count. So just past the edge of Cabarita Beach. I'm on 104 kilometers, so it's pretty good. So far it's taken me 5 hours and 18 minutes, and I have another 20K to go to get there. So can't wait, just wanna get there. I feel good at the moment, it's cooled down a fair bit. There's a bit of cloud covers rolled in. Pulled everything off nicely. So now I'm just cruising. So that amazing looking sign right in front of me there says, "Welcome to Queensland, back on home soil." I've got another 2 days of riding and then I'm home. Woohoo!
So So I'm here, made it. I'm in Coolangatta tonight. I so far have covered 938 kilometers on this ride, so that's pretty exciting. It's day 10. Today I covered 129 kilometers altogether, so that's the longest ride I've done today. So pretty proud of myself that I've done it, and that's the longest ride of the trip as well, so that's really exciting. I've got two more days left, so yeah, looking forward to it. As far as my body is, like my knees, I'm kind of a little worried that they're going to play up a little bit more during the trip. So I'm just going to make sure I stretch them really hard tonight and try and ice them and really try and massage them and make sure that they're not getting worse. Then I also, yeah, it makes such a difference riding on the freeway. I was clocking 25 to 30 knots the whole time for the last 2 hours, whereas the rest of the morning was doing 15 knots because the road was bad condition and there were lots of hills, so it really slows you down. But it was a good adventure. Hoping the knees heal, and apart from that, and apart from feeling really tired from doing such a long distance, I've been good. I think, let me just see how many hours. All up, it took me 6.5 hours. So that's straight 6.5 hours of pedaling, not stopping. Add on to that probably an hour for pit stops and grabbing food and refilling water. So all up, I've been on the road 7.5-8 hours, so it's a pretty long day, so I am really tired. And I'm gonna go have a shower and rest up for tomorrow. So riding to Brisbane tomorrow, so that's gonna be quite exciting and challenging, like all the different roads, and hopefully I won't get lost, and we'll see how we go.